to another wonderful day for us to talk about Arduino and all of the wonderful things that we're going to do with some of our electronics boards here. And this is number three. This is analog write. At this point, I'm assuming that you've already done a digital write and a digital read. That's an LED that blinks and a push button that reads some code and prints it to the serial monitor. And we're going to go ahead and we are going to talk about how to do something a little bit more complicated here. So if we pop our way over to number 1.07 here, the Arduino circuits, we are on number three. Now you'll notice that it has a few more points on here. That's just because we're going to be integrating some things to make this assignment work. That's going to make it a little more difficult, and there's nothing wrong with that. Our goal is going to be to hook up a dimming LED light and control it. Your assignment's eventually going to be to control an RGB LED with this. And we're going to do something similar to this. As per usual, we're going to do it in Tinkercad. We're going to do it in real life, and we're going to make the whole thing work. Now, I warn you in advance, today is a little bit more code than it is hardware. Our actual hardware that we're going to hook up today is actually going to be really, really simple. So let's start there. If we take a look at our actual hardware circuit here, for what we're going to be playing with in this particular code, any LED will do. In this case, I'm going to actually hook up an RGB LED, all right? Now, I've hooked this up in a very specific way. Now, I just want to float over to your Arduino board and talk about a couple things before we get started. The first is that we are going to be dealing with analog signals today. Now, an analog signal is very simply a signal that is not on or off. It can be a variable amount. So we could have a 50% signal, we could have a 32% signal, we could have a 71% signal. Those are all right. That's what analog is. It allows us to do half measures. It allows us to do kind of halfway gradients, gray areas. There's a bunch of words in the English language for that. Now, to do that, we have two options. You'll notice that these pins on the top of your Arduino are labeled digital pins. At the bottom here, we have actual analog pins, and we're going to play with them in our next assignment when we talk about using a potentiometer. But for our LEDs, we're going to use what I could best describe as a cheater's analog. Now, these digital pins up top here can only turn on and off. That's their only option. But we can actually use them as analog pins as well. And we're going to use what's called PWM to do that. Now, PWM is pulse width modulation. And I'm going to try to explain it in as simple way as I possibly can. PWM is basically where we flick the lights on and off, on and off, on and off really fast. And the longer the light stays on versus how long the light stays off is actually how much power you're going to run to the light. So let's say that you flick the light on and off 100 times in a second, but it's on just as often as it's off. That's a 50% PWM cycle. We call it a duty cycle. And PWM pins on the Arduino board are all of the ones that have this little tilde beside them, this little squiggly line, okay? So the tilde actually indicates that pins 3, 5, 6, 10, 9, 11 are all able to do PWM. That's awesome. You'll notice that my wires, rather than being linear, rather than doing 2, 3, 4, I've hooked them up to 3, 5, and 6 because I clearly want to use some analog space here. And basically, what we're going to do with this LED, we're going to make this thing dim from bright to from not bright to bright, and we're going to do it using code. Now, if you remember back to when you started doing coding, maybe you did the code.org thing, we used for loops quite frequently, and we're going to make use of a for loop today. I'm going to describe how they work, and we'll go from there. All right, notice that we do have the resistor here on the cathode. As per usual, I point that out for those of you that are going to do this in real life. In Tinkercad, blowing up an LED isn't problematic. In real life, well, you only have one RGB LED in your kit. Now, let's hop back to the assignment because I've actually given you the command that's going to allow us to do this. Because you'll notice, if you go to analog write, it actually takes you to a piece of code that is actually going to hook up a potentiometer. It's actually our next assignment. Okay, so we're going to go back and we're going to click on this new link that showed up here. This is the for command for Arduino. And let's talk our way through a for command. For command is basically letting us run multiple times through the same piece of code while changing something very slightly. And I'm going to walk you through the syntax on it by setting up our actual PWM command that we're going to work with here. Now, PWM commands on an Arduino work from a scale of 0 to 255. All right, and I'm just going to jump over here to my analog write command that I've built, and I'm going to dump this code in here. Now, let's walk our way through it. What this says is that we're going to dim an LED using a PWM pin. Okay. Now, we've created a variable at the start here. The variable is an integer variable, meaning it is a number. Okay. And we've got PWM pin. Again, how we name the variable, not terribly important. As long as it's not a word that's already being used somewhere else in the Arduino language, we're probably fine here. And we're going to make this equal to pin number 10. And I'm probably going to change this number once I get it onto my board, because I don't have anything hooked up to pin number 10 right now. I have a bunch of other pins. Now, we don't have any void setup here, but I'm going to make a recommendation personally that we do need a little bit of setup. We should probably set up pin mode on PWM pin, and we should probably set it to an output. All right. Now, the reason we do this is when we set up the pin as an input or an output, it changes its state. If the pin that you're using happened to be an input before on your real life board, it's actually not going to work. You're actually going to have a huge problem with this, because if it was set to an input before, it'll still be set to an input. It'll have a lot of resistance in that circuit, and the LED just won't light up. Now let's hop down to our actual for command, and this is kind of where the meat of all of this comes in. So for our for command, we've got three pieces of information that we need to give the for command to get started. The first one is we need to set our variable, obviously, that we're going to use to do the counting. And in this case, we're actually creating the variable right here in the for command. And we need to give it an initial value. So this first piece of information is the initial value for the for command. In this case, we've decided that the first value it's going to start at is going to be 0. The next thing is we have to put the condition on the for command. The condition is basically what this condition has to be met for the for command to run. So let's read this one. In this case, I starts at equaling 0. That's our initial. It says if I is less than or equal to 255, keep running this for command. That means that once I is greater than 255, once it reaches 256, we're going to stop running this for command. So this command is going to run until that point. And then we have this third piece here, which is I plus plus. Now you haven't seen this code before, but I plus plus is the same as if we'd written I equals I plus one. Those are the same command for all intents and purposes. The term I'm going to use for this is going to be, I'm going to call it incrementing something, okay? So incrementing simply means that every time we run this for command, we're going to add 1 to the variable I. If we did I minus minus, we could minus 1. Easy enough, okay? And that's a little bit of shorthand to make this easy. So let's read through this. We're going to start with I equals 0, and we're going to say as long as I is 255 or less, we are going to add 1 to I, and then we are going to run this code. And we're going to do this over and over and over again. This is going to happen 255 times. What it does is it's going to use an analog write command. Now, an analog write looks a lot like a digital write command in that it has the pin that you want to use. So in this case, PWM pin, which remember, the Arduino is going to read as, right now, the number 10, but the number of whatever I put in once I get it into my actual circuit. And then the letter I. Now the letter I, remember, changes as we run this for command. So each time we run this, it's going to be different. The first time we run it, I is going to equal 0. Okay, the 100th time we run this, I is going to equal 99. This is going to keep changing. Now, this is important because in an analog read, and again, if we want to, we can jump into the analog read and go to the reference, and we can see all of the pieces about this that says that, yes, this is going to allow us to do a PWM write, and when we go to our parameters, the value, okay, the duty cycle between 0, always off, and 255, always on. So this is going to give us a nice fader effect. And basically, we're just going to write that value there. We're going to delay by 10 milliseconds. The longer this delay, the slower the fade. I'm actually going to change this. I'm going to change this to 50. Now, let's grab this and throw this into Tinkercad very quickly. There's Tinkercad. Love it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to my code. I'm going to select this, and I'm going to dump it in. And I'm going to choose to make this LED go blue. Okay, my blue wire is on pin 5. So I just go to my variable at the top, and I change it to the number 5. Let's start our simulation. And what I should get is an LED that slowly fades from blue, pale blue, to very, very bright blue. Okay? That's awesome. I'm just going to test this in real life and show you what it looks like on a real Arduino board here. Let me just pop over. I'm just going to upload this code really quickly here. By the way, if I've messed with any formatting things, I can go to Tools and Auto Format to move stuff around. I'm going to click Upload in just a second here, but I'm going to jump over to my second webcam here for a second. And you can actually see my second webcam is already blinking blue. I'm going to try to blink it red, because I believe I have red on pin number 3. Okay, I'm going to change the value of my PWM pin to number 3, and I'm going to upload this. Now, what we should see the Arduino upload, and oh, maybe I have my, I think I might have my wires plugged in the wrong, they may be the wrong color, and that's okay. I'm just gonna upload a different code. I'm gonna go to pin number 5 now and see what happens. Hey, pin number 5 is green. That is correct. Nothing wrong with that. That means my red and my blue wires are just backwards on this circuit. By the way, this isn't anything fancy, guys. This is just 3 wires running into an RGB LED with a 220 ohm resistor on the side running into ground. That's all this is. Alright, well, let's hop back to Tinkercad because I want to take this a little bit further now. I want to go actually make this so we can control all 3 colors of the RGB LED. How we're going to do that is we're going to start renaming some variables. So the very first thing is I'm going to decide that my pin number 6, this is actually my red pin. So I'm going to go in and just change the name of this variable. Okay, I'm also going to change the camel case on it. So you guys notice that I added the word red in place of PWM, but I also capitalized the letter P. Now I can read this as red pin. Okay, now if I change this here, I also need to change this throughout my code. All right. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually, you know what I'm going to do one better? I'm just going to copy this over, and I am going to put a couple of new copies of it in here, and I'm just going to call them the blue pin. And I'm going to put the blue pin on pin number 5, and pin number 3 is going to be the green pin. Awesome. Let's spell things correctly. That matters in Arduino. Okay, same thing down here. I'm just going to grab my pin mode, and I'm going to put a couple more. This is where that auto format comes in. If I want to make those spaced out all easily, I just go to auto format at the top here. It lines them all up. I want them all to be, outputs, so we're just going to take these in. Green. There we go. Okay, now I'm just going to jump down here. Now, what I want to do for this code is I actually want to make it so that the one pin, the red pin, is going to go from not bright to fully bright, and then it's going to turn itself off. It's going to reset itself. So I'm just going to copy this code. And by the way, a lot of what we do here is going to be copying code. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, so red pin is going to go from 0 to 255, and then when it's all said and done, the red pin is going to go to 0. Okay, that kind of makes sense. I'm just going to grab this whole set of code, and I'm just going to go down, and I'm going to paste it a couple times. And now, if anybody's from the computer science world, you're staring at me right now going, why could you be so inefficient? Why don't you just use a function here? Guys, if you are able to work on a function at this point, if you're able to put a function into your code here, and you understand how that all works at this point, be my guest. Nothing wrong with that. There's a really good way to make this happen and make it way, way crisper and cleaner. That's okay. We're trying to teach a concept here. We will get that concept taught, and then we'll make it really good afterwards. All right? I'm just going to make this so that this is the blue pin here. Here in both cases, blue pin, and then I'm going to change this to the green pin, and this one's going to be the green pin as well. And I'm going to upload this. I'm going to actually not even worry about Tinkercad. I'm going to upload this straight to my actual board so you guys can see what happens here. We should have a fade into red. It should go from not very bright to very bright. My webcam isn't picking up that red terribly well, but that's okay. It's then going to set it red back to 0. This should take 250, there we go. Now it's going to green, and you're gonna see the green's gonna get brighter and brighter and brighter, and then it's gonna turn the green off, and it's gonna turn the blue on, and the blue is gonna go brighter and brighter and brighter. Clearly in my code I have a pin that's not quite labeled properly, but that's okay, it gets the point across. This is the basics of your analog write. It's the idea that you can use code to fade into something in a half measure. You don't have to just be on or off like the digital. And I hope you took something from that and maybe some of the coding pieces here. Good luck, happy coding, happy breadboarding, enjoy.